Hi, I'm Pastor Mike Lamar at Calvary Baptist Church in Rittman.
Greetings. I'm Pastor Bud from Grace Brethren Church here in Rittman.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ruthie Trigg, pastor at Rittman United Methodist Church.
Hi, this is Pastor Alex Barnes from the Milton Presbyterian Church.
Hello, my name is Jamie Freiberger. I'm the associate pastor of the South Main Street Church of God in Rittman.
Hi there, I am Thomas Dunn, the pastor at Crown Hill Mennonite Church.
I have been so encouraged by this church community, and I'm very happy to help out with this video in our shared encouragement to be united as one people in one community.
And I've noticed, as you did too, that we are living in a very tumultuous time.
There is so much going on in our country right now that is affecting every one of us in some way.
That's why it's so important in the current time that we have, with a lot of fear, the fear of the unknown, or the divisions, that we must be together as one.
The struggle is real, and we've been living it for quite a while now. But there is hope available. The struggles of the day may cause us to worry or fear. So how do we deal with this? We can find answers in the Bible.
And I'm glad that God told the nation of Israel 2,500 years ago in Isaiah 41:13, "For I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand, and I say to you, do not fear, I will help you."
No matter what is happening, we can trust in God to give us peace and to direct us to live to do what is best and right in our world.
The verse that I'd like to share is out of John chapter 13, as we're focusing on the theme of unity. "A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another, as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if ye have love one to another."
Now, I myself have been so blessed to be a part of the body of Christ and to feel the love of Jesus Christ, whom I profess to be my Lord and Savior. The Apostle Paul wrote about this in Philippians 2:1-3, and he challenges the believers. He says, "Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any common sharing of the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and of one mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of others." It is an active valuing. It is a lifting up of people to a place above yourselves.
And I want to share a scripture with you on unity, or being together. It's out of Genesis 11:6. It says, "And the Lord said, behold, the people was one, and they all have one language, and this they began to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them." He was referring to the people who were trying to build a tower to heaven because they wanted to see him. He simply reminds us that we all, if we put our minds together, can be one and can accomplish anything that we want to do.
On the basis of God's love to us, in that he gave his son, Jesus Christ, to die for us, since we are all sinners, that produced that love that brings about the unity amongst us.
This is what should unify us, and this is what will unify us.
In unity, we stand together. If we stand together, then there's nothing that this world can throw at us that we can't get through.
And I wanted to share with you from John 1:14. "The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us." This is a text we often hear at Christmas because it talks about Jesus coming to us. But I've been thinking about how important that is for our daily lives. This is the story of Jesus coming to us, the incarnation taking on flesh. And I heard a sermon recently where the minister, Brian Stevenson, challenged me on the power of proximity. He said that we are called to be proximal to all the people on this earth that are suffering, that are struggling, whatever the case may be. That's our call. Just like Jesus came to us and dwelt amongst us and was close to us, we are called to be close to those that are suffering, the least of those among us.
In Philippians 4:6-7, we find this. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all that He has done. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus.
Remember that 1 Peter says in chapter 5, verse 7, that God cares for us. We can cast our cares on Him because He cares. Isaiah heard from God in Isaiah 26:3 that God said, "You will keep in perfect peace him whose mind is steadfast because he trusts in you." Today, we have a God who cares, and we can trust in Him, and He promises us a peace that passes all understanding.
The other hope is that we can pull together in the struggle as we live in a world of so much that is unknown. Let's consider how we can respond in the most positive ways possible.
So unity begins with us. We pull together, we keep going, we keep heading in the right direction.
My hope is that we would be together as one in serving the Lord with all that we have, loving Him with our heart, soul, mind, body, and strength, and then loving our neighbor as ourselves.
It always comes back to the two commandments that Jesus Christ left for us. In Matthew chapter 22, verses 37 through 39, Jesus tells us, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment, and the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself." This is very clear. This is how we need to live to make things right.
And so we are to make sure that that unity or that love abounds more and more. We're to love each other deeply and care deeply about those around us, especially our communities.
We as a community can work together to encourage and support each other through the rough times.
As our churches are trying to determine what to do and how to survive during this time of virus and violence, it's good to remember the words of Jesus when He said, "I will build my church and the gates of COVID-19 cannot prevail against it." I think that's not exactly what He said, but you know the point. God is in control and God cares about us. And He wants us to love, respect each other. In fact, the scriptures tell us we're to give preference to each other.
Do you really consider actively lifting others above yourselves? Do you consider that not just for your the other people who are like-minded and who believe the same things as you do, but also for people outside of that group?
God has to come first. Other people then come second, and then us. Our wishes should be the last things to be considered in all things.
Do you view other people and the words that you speak to them to both challenge them and love them in a gentle and compassionate way?
There's a lot of opinions out there. There's so many views, even among the followers of Christ, that we need to just be focused on what God's Word says. In Philippians 4:8, it reminds us, "Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, pure, lovely, admirable, think about these things." That's very excellent advice as we try to remember how to love ourselves back together and how to love reaching other people for Christ as well.
And on the basis of the fact that we have the Holy Spirit indwelling us, He gives us that power to have that new kind of love that we've never had before, to be united. That's where our unity comes from.
Let's all work together to make Rittman, this country, and this world the best that it can be for everyone. Have a good day.
And so my prayer for myself, for my church, and for all of Rittman and anyone who hears this video is that we could be proximal to people and see the power of the gospel move when we are proximal to those that are in need.
I hope this encouraged you. I trust that you will have a wonderful day. May God richly bless you.
May God keep you safe, healthy, and blessed.